हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, इवोल्यूशन ऑफ पैरासिटिज्म इन माइक्रोब्स। अर्लियर वी हैव स्टडीड पैथोजेनेसिस, हाउ पैथोजन एंटर्स इन द होस्ट और हाउ इट प्रिपेयर्स इटसेल्फ फॉर द पेनिट्रेशन। नाउ वी विल डिस्कसिंग अ न्यू टॉपिक, इवोल्यूशन ऑफ पैरासिटिज्म। एज वी ऑल नो देर आर पैरासाइट्स जो हैं, दे इन्फेक्ट द होस्ट प्लांट्स एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द पैथोजेनेसिस और द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ डिजीज इन द माइक्रोब्स। वी ऑल नो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ पैरासाइट्स, ऑब्लिगेट पैरासाइट्स एंड द फैकल्टेटिव पैरासाइट्स। ऑब्लिगेट पैरासाइट्स आर दोज माइक्रोब्स which are not able to generate or prepare in laboratory through the tissue culture techniques, like viruses, albugo, puccinia, erysiphe, claviceps, etc. These microorganisms we cannot produce in artificial conditions in the laboratory. That's why they are known as obligate parasite. These obligate parasites are pathogenic for the plants and animals. In plants, they after the entering in the host or after the pathogenesis process completes, they perform or they create different types of symptoms according to the damage they do in the host cells. The symptoms generates in the form of wilt, rot, mildew, ergot, yellowing, chlorosis, etc. As we all know, wilt infects the vascular tissue, rot infects vascular as well as stem or leaf part, mildew affects on leafy part, ergot on seed, yellowing, chlorosis. These are the symptoms of mycoplasma and viruses, and they affect the leafy part. Now the question is, how these parasites evolve in the nature? This is a topic of debate, the whether the parasites evolve from the saprophytes or the saprophytes evolve from the parasites. We all know what is the saprophytes. What are the saprophytes? Saprophytes, the microorganism, stay or live on the dead organic matter and obtain their food from decaying or dead materials are known as saprophytes. Here they are also of two types, obligate saprophytes and facultative saprophytes. Obligate saprophytes are non-pathogenic in nature because they obtain their food from the dead and decaying organic matter. They do not affect the living part of the plants or animals. Facultative saprophytes are those which pass their life in the form of saprophyte, but when they enter in the host or the living organism, they can also create symptoms there and survive. Also can survive in the living tissues like Ostilego fungi. We all know Ostilego is a pathogenic facultative saprophyte. It is a pathogenic. It affects the seeds or seeds of the host. In between these two parasites and the saprophytes, we all know there is a different group of organisms which we know symbionts. They are not saprophytes, they are not parasites. They do not harm the host or create diseases like parasites, or they do not remain on the dead organisms like saprophytes, but they live together. They are the organisms or two as association of two organisms where two organisms live together and help to each other in any way. For example, we all know lichens. Here, in lichen, algae and the fungi both remain in association. We all know algae is a chlorophyllous part of the lichen, and fungi is the non-chlorophyllous part. Chlorophyllous part means it is autotrophic, whereas fungi is heterotrophic. It cannot synthesize its food itself. Therefore, in lichens, fungi is unable to synthesize its food, but algae is synthesizing its food for the fungal part also. In this way, algae is helping to the fungi also. Similarly, lichens are found on the rocks where there is no minerals and availability of water as it is found in the soil. So what help it is needed from the fungal part? Fungi remains in association like roots or rhizoids of the other plants and absorb water from the atmosphere. Similarly, it excrete some chemicals on the rocks. These chemicals convert rock into some minerals which algae can absorb and use these minerals for the synthesis of its food. Thus, we had seen how in symbiosis of lichen, both the partner lichen as well as fungi, autotrophic part and heterotrophic part, both are helping each other and they both are living together without the association. Without this association of two, nobody can survive in the nature. This is the lichen, and the process is termed as symbiosis. Sim matlab together, biosis matlab living together of two different organisms, and both are helping in any way to each other. Similarly, mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza is the association of higher plants and fungi. In these plants, fungi works to absorb nutrients. It also work here as rhizoids and absorb nutrients from the atmosphere and water and minerals from the atmosphere and give to the plants as on which it is staying. Thus, mycorrhiza is also a symbiotic association where two living organisms are staying together and helping to each other. Mycorrhiza association, fungi is getting food from the plant where it is staying. Thus, we don't know. It is the topic of evolution. This topic of evolution of parasitism is the topic of debate. Either parasites evolve, saprophytes are evolved from this line of evolution, parasites, then they converted into symbiotes and then they converted into saprophytes, or whether saprophytes slowly converted into symbionts and they finally transform into the parasites. Thus, this is the topic how evolution of the parasitism of the organisms takes place. In this topic, we had studied various types of parasites, symbiosis and saprophytes, and how they can evolve their line of evolution. Thus, it is yet not clear till today what is the line of evolution. It is progressive or it is retrogressive. Progressive means saprophytes to parasites or parasites to saprophytes. So that in evolution we study, where it is not clear the thing, we study both the things, progressive as well as retrogressive evolution processes, where we are not very clear which part of the which stage is more advanced or which stage is the least advanced, we studied two, both the two paths. Thus, we had completed our this topic, evolution of pathogenesis, evolution of parasitism in plants. Now, in other class, next class, we will study next topic. Thank you.